College, E-learning.
Good morning, y'all. Hope you're doing good. I'm Arya, Department of Software Development and System Administration. I'm handling Computer Organization and Architecture. So, today we start with a new module, that is Introduction to Computer Organization and Architecture. And the previous class, we just discussed the syllabus we have. And today we are starting with our syllabus, that is Computer Organization and Architecture, and we start with the functional units of a computer system. So, what are the different basic functional units of a computer system? The computer system consists of input units, output units, memory, processor and ALU, that is control unit. Okay. So, according to this organization of a computer system, we should know about what is a computer and what are the components, then we can go for the architecture of computer system. So, basically we are starting from the architecture or the functional units of a computer system. Okay. So, as you know that what is an input unit? An input unit means the data which we given by the user through the input board or keyboard. We can say that it's a keyboard. Through the keyboard we are entering the data into the system. Okay. And the second functional unit of a computer system is storage unit, that is the data you are storing inside the storage unit. And the next component is output unit, that is the display unit. The processed data is showing to the user is known as the output unit. And the major thing units are the control unit and ALU, that is the control, the function of the control unit is to control all the activities or the functions, all the resources inside the computer system. And ALU is arithmetic and logic unit, there process all kind of arithmetic and logical operations. Okay. So, we can go for in depth, that is the first one, input unit. In input unit, the computer is to read the data, and most commonly we are using the input data is or input unit is keyboard, mouse, joystick, etc. And this input unit helps to convert the data, user data into machine language. According to the conversion of data, we can say that its input unit, it reads the data from the keyboard and it sends to the various devices of the system. Then the next one is central processing unit. The function of central processing is the brain of the computer system, and it stores the data and coordinate all the functions of the computer system. And the next one is the memory unit. The major part or major function of the memory unit is to store the data, that is storage unit, and we are classifying this memory as primary memory and secondary memory. The primary memory is RAM and the secondary memory is ROM, and this primary memory is volatile, which means that whenever the power is turned off, the data that you are working with is lost. In the case of ROM, read-only memory, which is used for storing the data in future. And we are classifying this as different kind, that is PROM, EROM, PEROM, etc. And also we are using the flash memory also. And the next one is arithmetic and logic unit. The main purpose of arithmetic and logic unit is to perform all the arithmetic and logical operations inside the computer system. And arithmetic unit consists of all the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. And the logical operation, it perform the logical operation, that is relational operations and making the decisions. Okay, this kind of operations performed inside the arithmetic and logical unit. Then next one is the output unit. In this output unit, the primary function of the output unit is to produce the result to the user, and the most common output device is the monitor of the computer system. So, regarding the functional units of a computer system, we were discussing about what is a computer. That is, computer is used for the storing data, and the major components or functional units of a computer system, we discussing that the input unit, storage unit, output and control, and arithmetic and logic unit. So, next we can go for the next topic, that is the basic operational concepts of the computer system. In this basic operation of the computer system is mainly focused on different registers and control unit and the memory. Okay, so from the figure you can see that it contains a memory, then different type of registers and general purpose registers and ALU, and these are contained in the processor. And we can go for the various, what is the functions of each registers and memory here. So, as you know, the memory is used for storing the data, and memory is classified into different, that is RAM, ROM, primary memory, secondary memory, etc. And again coming to the different kind of registers, that is a register is storing one bit of information, and we are classifying this register as different, that is there is a general purpose register is there and special purpose registers is there. In the case of the general purpose registers, we are just naming as R1, R2, etc. and we end as Rn minus 1, which means that the end of the registers. And again the special purpose registers, the most common special purpose registers are program counter, instruction register, MIR and MDR. Okay. So, I repeat once more, that is a memory, the basic operational concept in computer system is the parts are memory, registers, processor and ALU and also control unit. So, the registers are classified into two, that is general purpose registers and special purpose registers. In the case of general purpose registers, they are used for small kind of operation, that is adding, subtracting, etc. And in the case of special purpose registers, as is the name implies, it having a special purpose, and there are four special purpose registers. The first one is MIR, MDR, PC and IR. That is the first purpose of PC, that is program counter. PC means program counter, it stores the address of the next instruction to be executed. PC means program counter, which is used for store the address of the next instruction to be executed. And IR, that is instruction register, the purpose of instruction register is holding the address of instruction that is currently executed. Okay, there is a difference between the PC and IR, that is PC means it stores the instruction address of the instruction that is going to execute, and IR is instruction register which hold the address of the instruction currently execute. Okay. So, the next two type of registers are MIR and MDR, and this MIR hold the address of the main memory to or from which the data to be transferred. That is, if you are doing some calculations or performing some operations with the help of MIR, you are transferring the data from or to memory. And the next one is MDR, that is data register, memory data register, and the purpose is to return into or read from the address or address location from the main memory. Okay, so to there are four special purpose registers are there, instruction register, program counter, MIR and MDR, and each having their own purposes. And coming into the control unit, what is the purpose of control? That is, control unit is used for controlling all the activities inside the computer system and also the calculations among the various various registers, various data transfer instructions or buses, etc. Then processor, that is the, what is the purpose of a processor? That is, processor coordinate all the activities inside the computer system, and also it is classified as control unit and ALU. As we learned, ALU is used for all the arithmetic and logical operations. In the case of a control unit, which coordinate all the activities inside the computer system. Okay. So, let us discuss one more time, that is basic operational concept. And this basic operational concept, the instructions are executed inside the computer system with the help of memory, registers and control unit, also with the ALU. And we discussed that this instruction means it's a combination of data, and this combination of data is referred to as instruction. How we can store the data inside the computer system, that is with the help of registers, memory and ALU. Okay. So, what are the major registers are used? Two type of registers are there: general purpose registers and special purpose registers. In the case of special purpose registers, they are 4: MAR, MDR, PC and IR. And general purpose registers are R1, R2 up to Rn-1. Okay. So, these are the topics today we were discussing.